Here we are. Hi, guys. Well, we were rolling on a different Ustream channel, but we're here now.
Hopefully they enjoyed what we had to say.
We are going to find a way to edit it all together, so yes. No worries. But to everyone who's wondering where we are, hi.
Hey, we're here. We're here.
Okay, so we were up to our book review portion of the show, so you didn't miss too much. So what we had wanted to touch on for this book review was that it's not just about your weight and health and fitness, it's also about your organs and your body and the importance of thinking about, you know, keeping your heart healthy.
That's right.
During the holiday season, mm-hmm. as well. So heart 401 tips for heart healthy holidays. So overeating, excess alcohol, stress, lack of exercise can all contribute to cardiac issues, especially over the holidays. The first pointer that they bring up is stress. Stress can trigger heart attacks. Emotional stress is probably one of the reasons that more people die of heart attacks on Christmas Day than any other day of the year. So this article is actually,
wow.
Yeah, talking about the holidays. That's from Thanksgiving horrible. Through New Year's.
It's so really important.
The first tip for the Thanksgiving holiday is to kind of limit your stress over the holidays if you can. Schedule some time for relaxation and exercise. Don't pack your holiday schedule with an hour-by-hour list of commitments, parties, and visits. And if you know the thing that you're supposed to do this year is really stressful, try to plan something different if you can.
Yeah.
You know, and just when you're planning for the holiday, especially if you're having a lot of guests over, do what you can to minimize your stress and start planning early. We have some really cool tips on how to organize yourself and get going early from a greatest article as well.
Mm-hmm.
They talk about diet. It's easy to put on a few pounds, obviously, between Thanksgiving and New Year's. They're not going to suggest that you begin a whole weight loss regime now, but your goal for the holiday season should be just to not gain, just to maintain. Pay attention to your portion sizes, to your desserts. Make a single trip to the buffet, favor lean meats, high fiber, fruits and vegetables. And if you must have dessert, just choose one item and preferably something small. Also talking a little bit about alcohol, we also have an article to share on that. More alcohol increases the risks of a wide variety of health problems, ranging from abnormal health rhythms to liver damage. Moderate consumption of any sort of alcohol is associated with heart health. So if you're going to have a couple of drinks over the holiday season, just remember to drink in moderation. You'll feel better overall. Nobody wants to be hungover during the holidays anyway.
Yeah, and why fill up on that when there's so many good things
exactly.
to eat?
And then, of course, exercise. Reserve some time for your exercise over the holidays. Go for a walk with your relatives who are over after dinner. Play with your kids. You know, organize a family game of touch football. Anything you can do to just avoid just sitting around, watching football, eating, talking. You know, try to make it a little more of an active day so everyone kind of benefits from that. For gift ideas, this is something I love. And I know that actually Hanukkah starts, I think, the night before Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are going to be giving gifts over this Thanksgiving holiday, remember, not everybody needs a scarf or another tie. It's going to sit in their closet until the spring. Think about giving someone something different, a health club membership, running shoes, a bicycle, fruit basket. I know everyone laughs about that, but you can't go wrong with like a healthy edible arrangement if you're bringing a host gift over. Something
take
with
a basket
fruit.
Of jellies.
Seriously.
Or that's a gift not healthy certificate. At all.
Yeah. I'm like, wait, what? Jellies aren't that bad. All natural preserves. That's nice.
That's true.
Goes along with this next gift, which is a gift certificate to a farmer's market. I would absolutely love that. And then for the new year, which we will talk more about the holidays later on, but resolve around this time of year to check your numbers, go to the doctor, get a physical, see where your levels are at. And, you know, for the new year, instead of saying I'm going to lose this number of pounds, say maybe I just want to get my cholesterol down, or I want to, you know, get everything under control there, and just resolve to make, you know, yourself a more healthy heart in the new year. So thought that was really
very
cool.
Nice.
We'll
that's
obviously
very cool.
Post that on 4C.
Very cool. The recipe rundown for tonight is actually based on Thanksgiving leftovers.
Which is Lisa's jam.
Because, yeah, that is totally my jam. I wish, you know, I miss eating bread only because one of my favorite things to do is just, like, pile everything that's left over from Thanksgiving onto a sandwich or in a roll.
Which is what your recipe pretty much is.
But it is because it's actually a Thanksgiving leftover Monte Cristo sandwich from Family Fresh Cooking. So basically, they actually suggest you to use Ezekiel bread, which is just sprouted grain bread.
Mm-hmm.
Because love. It toasts really well, and we know this because we've had it before. Absolutely love Ezekiel bread. So it's the Ezekiel bread. It's cranberry sauce. We know leftover cranberry sauce, sweet potatoes, the turkey, and then basically, I mean, it tells you everything else that you should put in it, but I would just put on whatever you want. You want the mashed potatoes, even throw on some green beans.
Yeah. Well, how is this a healthy recipe, Lisa?
Gravy. Well, what's a some gravy?
No, because you showed me the recipe. Do we not have it here? We're going to
post it. No, we do have it. We're going to post it.
The Ezekiel bread is healthy.
The point is...
Oh, yeah, we have it here.
...that I'm really hoping that you decide to make healthy versions of all of these side dishes.
Right.
That's up to you.
Because... Two pieces of Ezekiel or whole wheat bread, sliced turkey breast, brie cheese, an ounce is not bad, cranberry sauce, roasted sweet potatoes.
Yeah.
Everything I said. Egg whites, pinch of salt. Yeah, that's not. It's not like the whole kitchen sink.
It's not because sorry, I lied. Because this is I'm just dreaming here.
She is. She was going off on a tangent.
I'm like, look at this great leftover sandwich, and this is what how I'm gonna make it. But I will post the recipe. The point is, it's up to you to make the healthy Thanksgiving so that you can have your healthy Thanksgiving leftover sandwich.
Perfect. Love it. Moving and for on. The cheat of the week. Our friend Freya is a foodie and a half in the kitchen.
And a half.
She came up with an amazing recipe all on her own. Don't even know. And I can cook, but I couldn't do this.
Love it.
She made gluten-free, somewhat paleo, pumpkin chocolate chip cookies. Delicious. We were lucky enough to be the beneficiaries of 4 cookies.
I just remember they're home.
Yeah, there's 2 more at home.
Yeah.
Thanks, Freya. So she used ingredients like... She used butter. If you want to make them paleo, you can use clarified butter. Coconut oil, stevia, which is like the most exciting part to me because there's no really added sugar in them except for what's in the semi-sweet chips that she got from Trader Joe's, which is amazing.
I'm so hungry right now.
Some people think, stevia, are they going to taste artificial? They don't at all. They're completely delicious. Pumpkin puree, eggs, vanilla, this whole amazing recipe we will share and post. Freya was amazing enough to share with all of us.
Yes.
And
thank you so much, Freya.
Wants to perfect it and hopefully we'll have more recipes from her soon. But check out the gluten-free pumpkin chocolate chip cookies. They're a great holiday idea.
Yummy.
Really good. Cheat of the week.
Ta-da. So, moving on to really the meat of it all.
Yeah.
The weekly theme.
No pun intended, the meat.
The meat. The meat and the mashed potatoes. Thanksgiving. So, the holiday season often derails Michelle and I. Mm-hmm. And what I mean by derail, I mean 10 plus pounds.
Yeah.
Not a joke.
Not kidding.
So, this is a very serious holiday season coming up.
It's taken us 5 years to lose 240 pounds.
Because we're Italian, and we love Thanksgiving, and then Christmas comes along, and you don't even want to know how many courses we're eating at Christmas.
I think this year we're determined, though, to...
Yeah, this is why I'm saying this is serious
this
now.
This is serious.
We are determined to maintain, and I know Michelle might even try to lose a pound.
I will be losing. I will not be maintaining. I will be losing.
She's going to try to lose a pound.
So last year was our first time that we made all the sides for our family for Thanksgiving dinner. And I guess because it was our first year, we were ambitious, and we basically made enough for an army.
Not even kidding.
We just threw out last year's Thanksgiving leftovers that were in our freezer almost a year.
Oh my God, don't say that. It's so wasteful.
I know, but we didn't eat them because we were like, we're going to be back on track. And we were, but we weren't. Anyway, it all went to waste. So I guess one of my first tips is don't overdo it the way we did. This year,
we're actually, we're having Thanksgiving at our place.
Small.
Just a small little gathering. And we're doing Whole Foods catering because they have a whole menu and they have all organic things and healthy things. And so we're really excited about that.
Yeah. So
we tried to find an option that was going to work for us and our diet, yet we could still enjoy ourselves.
And we know now to definitely not overdo it.
Definitely.
And if you can't control and you're not hosting and you're going to someone's house, get your family on board, share your goals with them, ask them if you can maybe bring a healthy alternative. If you want to have gluten-free stuffing, ask your aunt, your grandma, your mom, whoever's hosting, if you can bring your own stuffing or your own cranberry sauce that has no added sugar. I'm sure if your family will be proud of you and happy that you have a commitment to being healthy. If you're hosting, You know, I'm sure your family won't even notice if you slip in some healthy recipes because they really don't taste much differently.
No,
at all.
Not at all.
So, just think about taking control in that way and getting everyone on board.
And if you do decide to go all out, just, be honest with yourself. This is what I'm going to do. And I will absolutely positively, have the strength to get back on track and not let it be an entire month of gaining weight.
Yeah. So, I mean, we're going to have a few gluten-free treats. We're not going to totally deprive ourselves, but we're going to stick to the day try to avoid having leftovers, because for us, Thursday becomes Friday, becomes Saturday, becomes Sunday, and then it's 4 days of eating and 10 pounds later.
Right, so, and then here come all the holiday parties in December.
Right, so try to stick to that one day if you're going to enjoy and just be done with it and enjoy and don't beat yourself up about it.
Definitely.
So Greatest has an ultimate illustrated guide.
Oh, that's where the ultimate, I was like, why is Greatest giving you an ultimatum?
Nope.
Ultimate. Trying to figure where that came up.
The ultimate illustrated guide to a healthy Thanksgiving. Really cool. Obviously, we will be posting this. So they say between pre-turkey day stress, all the planning, lack of physical activity, and the big meal itself, it's not exactly the healthiest day of the year. They, in this guide, share smart eating strategies, workout tips, and ways to stay active all week long and to help you have a physically and mentally happier holiday. Guys, sometimes I just can't speak. It happens. Maybe it's because we do the show after work. After a long day.
I think so.
Whatever it is.
Should we greet everybody like a morning show?
We should. Anyway, they give you a whole outline what to do 3 weeks before for Thanksgiving and for yourself, what to do 2 weeks before, what to do the weekend before, what to do Monday. What is so funny now?
I don't know.
Should we greet the show like a morning show? As you swirl laughing. Your teeth?
I guess.
I can't.
I didn't see myself on camera, so I can't laugh.
Anyway.
But I am.
What to do the weekend before, the Monday, the Tuesday, the Wednesday, and actually on Thanksgiving Day.
This is really fun.
It's really, really cool.
And it is illustrated.
It is fully illustrated, fully informational. And they also talk about, in the midst of all this planning that you're doing for this holiday, you're also going to plan to do a turkey trot, a 5K.
That's right.
Yeah. So
you're doing
really
it all.
Exciting. So the whole point, though, is really to just plan and think about yourself and your health and to not kind of get lost
first
in the craziness of
That's
the
right.
holiday. Lisa will plan this, post this on the blog, and it's really helpful.
And it's super cute, too.
Yeah, definitely.
So on to the tips. For a thinner Thanksgiving day, tip number one is to eat breakfast. We're serious people. And you don't have to go all out. Doesn't have to be some fancy pumpkin French toast pancake extravaganza. But have breakfast.
Yeah, a lot of people think because they're going to eat crazy all day that they should skip breakfast, but that's actually going to make you hungrier.
Right, and you got to kind of get your body going and ready for the day, for all the burning of the calories that you're going to need. Start with the metabolism up. And if you want something quick, because we understand when you're cooking on the day and you're having company, there's not a lot of time, but there is an awesome pumpkin coffee nut Shakeology.
Yes.
That you can make for yourself, and it's really simple and super yummy and festive.
We have a photo.
We have a photo.
It's coming. There.
Thank you, Sean, for slowing me down for a minute. So, I'm going to post this whole recipe on the blog, but it's coconut extract, unsweetened canned pumpkin, pumpkin pie spice, a cup of cold coffee, and chocolate Shakeology. And there you are. You're feeling festive and fun, and you're eating breakfast, and you're not going to starve yourself for the next 6 hours while the turkey's in the oven, and your metabolism is up.
And if you don't have Shakeology, put a scoop of chocolate or vanilla or whatever whey protein.
Put whey protein, and yeah, definitely.
Because then you're getting extra protein there, too.
Work that out.
Get that started. So after eating breakfast, you basically, the second tip is to lighten up. So there's a lot of healthy recipes, like beyond a lot of healthy recipes online. The first one that we have is if you are someone who follows the paleo diet from Paleo.
Or maybe you don't.
Right?
Because these are still good.
Exactly. But just trying to have a little something for everyone. Paleo MG. She has amazing recipes, and she posts all of them in her Thanksgiving recipe roundup. We will put the link up for that. We've actually pinned some of these. She has a pumpkin granola. She breaks it down by breakfast, sides, and desserts. She's got apple fritters, pumpkin bread, French toast. Now remember that all this is paleo, so it's going to be gluten-free as well.
Gluten-free, dairy-free.
Right. Banana bread, French toast, 5-ingredient breakfast, and acorn squash. Breakfast stuffed acorn squash. Really? Can't read. Can't speak.
That's okay.
I don't know my deal is.
We still love
blueberry
you.
Donuts with blueberry lemon jam. Easy crock pot breakfast pie. Caramel apple pancakes.
She likes breakfast.
Chocolate waffles. Those are all the breakfasts. The sides, we have just a few.
I like breakfast.
Crock pot sweet potato basil soup.
I really want to make
really,
that.
Really want to try
really
that.
Really want to make that.
Bacon and chives sweet potato biscuits.
I really want to make that too.
Yeah, that looks amazing. What else?
But we're doing the catering thing.
On to dessert, we have pumpkin cheesecake, of course, which is a gluten-free crust, which is amazing. Chewy pecan pie brittle, that looks really good too. Really great recipe. So there are resources out there.
That's right.
We'll post the link. Check that out.
The Food Network also has healthy Thanksgiving recipes. And one of them that caught my eye was this sweet potato pecan casserole, which we will also post as well. The whole link to all of the recipes from Food Network if you prefer to go a little more mainstream.
Right. She had, that one had no marshmallows, right?
That's right. It's just sweet potatoes and pecans and a couple other
guys, fun things. I know we're keeping it healthy, but I'm having marshmallows. Sorry.
Well, we'll get to the calorie slashing.
I know.
You may rethink that.
I know. We also have 32 Thanksgiving recipes for a healthier holiday from Greatest. Hey, you're in my pile.
Oh, so sorry.
Greatest shared a bunch of really cool ones. They have a spicy kale salad, a spinach salad, a curried pumpkin soup, cranberry orange sauce with thyme. They even have a few cocktails on there. So check those out on Greatest.
And then there is the 50 Thanksgiving leftover recipes.
Is that where you got your sandwich?
That is where I got my sandwich.
Very,
so
very
50
cool.
Totally awesome recipes. Some of the links are broken, so sorry about that, which is disappointing. But these even have appetizers, breakfast that you can make with your Thanksgiving leftovers, pizzas, burgers, casseroles, and pies. Oh, my. Pasta, sandwiches and wraps, salads. So really, you know, it's really good, especially to with the leftovers to make
we'll
a salad.
We'll be making a lot of turkey salad.
We will.
Or turkey soup.
Cranberries.
So the third tip is to police your portions. This is really important. And this is a place where I know that sometimes I drop the ball. There was one year we were at Lisa's family for Thanksgiving many moons ago when I was still very overweight. I ate so much. I was literally ill. Like, very sick.
I don't know if I remember this.
I was on the couch at your mom's, like, in doubled over pain. It was bad.
Wow.
Yeah, that was a weak moment for
me. It must have been tasty food, though.
It was really good.
I mean, Thanksgiving with my mom is always great.
So, I mean, Thanksgiving with all our family.
Yeah. Forget about it. We can't get away from it.
So, according to Greatest, the average American gobbles down more than 4,500 calories on Turkey Day. But by policing your portions, that number can easily be slashed. 4,500 calories is like my calories for 4 days.
Did you know that there's 3,500 calories in a pound?
Oh, well, there you go. So you just gained a pound on Thanksgiving Day.
That's all. That's not bad.
Well, I guess.
Uh-oh. Don't tell me that.
Yeah, really. So follow this serving size guide for a smarter but still enjoyable holiday meal. For turkey, you're going to have about a 4-ounce portion, which is a deck of cards. And they say to just be careful because 32 grams of protein, which is in 4 ounces, is more than half of what's recommended daily. So I don't say that it's bad to overdo it on turkey. If you're going to overdo it on anything, overdo it on the turkey. But, you know, keep your portions in check. Cranberry sauce can pack a lot of added sugar, especially if it comes in a can.
Especially the canned one.
Yeah. But if you have someone in your family who makes it, I know my mom makes a delicious one, but she does add sugar. So, you know, maybe you could try stevia instead. Might want to consider doing that.
Nice
but
tip there.
They say that the equivalent serving size should be a spool of thread, just so you have a visual when
what
you're
about
there.
One of those mini spools?
Regular spool should be fine.
Okay.
For a dinner roll, the equivalency should be 1 tennis ball, so that means don't overdo it.
That's a bummer, man.
I don't know why they're putting a serving size on Brussels sprouts, because I love Brussels sprouts.
There's 4 Lego men.
4 Lego men or 4 Brussels sprouts, and watch out for recipes that sneak in cheese, butter, or lots of oils, which makes Brussels sprouts tastier for most people.
Mm-hmm.
For gravy, they say about a golf ball size.
Boo. Okay, no, that's great.
Stuffing. Well, the point is that we're real people just like you guys. So for us, it's a challenge as well. So that was kind of one of the reasons why we started the show, to share, you know, these are challenging events for us too.
Definitely struggle.
For stuffing, they say the equivalency of a bar of soap, and opt for whole wheat if you can. For us, it will be gluten-free. For cornbread, the size should be about a master lock, a padlock, one of your gym locks. Sweet potato casserole, the size should be equivalent to an Altoids box. Mashed potatoes, equivalent to a roll of scotch tape, one of those dispenser ones.
Yeah.
Not just the roll. Pumpkin pie, the size should be equivalent to about a light bulb. So once that's done, you have a whole plate of a lot of great food, and you're still getting to enjoy everything, but you're not making yourself sick. So
try to stick around that area.
Yeah, or just don't go back for seconds. Take a little scoop of everything and call it a day.
And then the next tip.
Yeah.
Slow
Lisa, really?
Slowly savor your plate of Thanksgiving food.
That was kind of uncomfortable.
Was that awkward for you?
Just a little awkward. Sean liked it.
Slowly savor your plate. Although I have a very hard time slowing down on Thanksgiving. As soon as the full plate is in front of me, I need to just like pick it up. No. It is a celebration for me. So I tried. Sometimes I rush right through it.
But Lee, are you celebrating the food or are you celebrating Thanksgiving?
I'm celebrating me and how good I feel. No, yeah, it's true.
Yeah.
I need to slow down and remember the reason for the season.
Absolutely. Go easy on alcohol. We found a really cool article. I know we had shared one before from Greatest, but Cooking Light actually has healthy holiday cocktails. And they talk about all the benefits of the different ingredients you can put in the cocktails, like pomegranate, cranberry, and cinnamon,
which are all real good
found in holiday libations.
Cocktail.
Yeah. Cranberries are a seasonal powerhouse. These powerful antioxidants can maintain cell structure and eliminate toxins in the body. You can make a cranberry cosmopolitan. Cinnamon is another powerful antioxidant. It's actually currently under research for its potential to help regulate blood sugar and inhibit tumor growth. I put cinnamon in everything.
Wow.
So that's
amazing. She really does.
They said don't hesitate to put cinnamon on everything this holiday because it's so good for you.
Just like I put hot sauce on it.
You can make an Applejack spiked hot cider.
Yummy.
Pomegranate actually is one of the most powerful antioxidants. One glass of pomegranate juice has the same cancer-fighting polyphenol content as 2 glasses of red wine and 10 cups of green tea.
Holy smokes.
1 glass of pomegranate juice. So you can make a sparkling pomegranate cocktail. Red wine, heart healthy, brain stimulating, age prolonging, cancer fighting. Certain components of red wine might play an important role in preventing damage to blood vessels, reducing bad cholesterol, preventing blood clots, improving blood flow, and inhibiting the development of certain cancers. So why not whip up a blood orange sangria?
Sangria.
Coffee.
That's a good choice.
Yeah. 1 to 2 cups of coffee in moderation actually are good for you, may help reduce cardiovascular disease, diabetes, Parkinson's, and help preserve cognitive skills such as memory and comprehension. So maybe an Irish coffee. Eggnog. They actually suggest a healthier eggnog. They give you a recipe for it. It's a good source of calcium and protein, but a typical 6-ounce glass of eggnog can set you back nearly 435 calories and 30 grams of fat.
Oh.
So you might want to try their version for 147 calories and 2.3 grams of fat for a half a cup.
That's not bad.
Absolutely. Chocolate and cocoa are naturally rich in antioxidants called flavanols. Be sure to look for the Dutch processed cocoa. Avoid milk chocolate. Chocolate has been reported to lower LDL, promote healthy blood flow, and may even lower your blood pressure, which is essential at this time of year because people are under stress. Chocolate does contain both calories and fat, so consume it sparingly. You might want to try a peppermint stick hot chocolate. And we did not forget you beer drinkers. Beer may actually protect bone mineral density because beer contains high levels of dietary silicon, which enables the deposit of calcium and other minerals in bone tissue. So they suggest trying a black velvet. But of course, the caveat is anything in moderation. So remember that excessive drinking may not only increase your risks for some diseases and cancers, it can also add a lot of calories, like Lisa said. So save those calories for your yummy food and try to keep the alcohol consumption down.
And drink responsibly.
Right. But if you're going to have a couple of drinks, these are some great options.
Thanks, Michelle.
Sure.
And let's be realistic. We're going to strive for maintenance.
We said.
Not loss.
Absolutely.
Sorry.
Am I in your pile?
No, I got very excited. Strive for maintenance, not loss. That's what I'm striving for. I'm also striving for not getting to the point where like my entire body hurts after I've eaten.
You have to remind me of that. When we cheat, our body actually hurts.
Everything
like
does.
Your tissues hurt. So
like my shirt on my body hurts me.
Yeah. It's weird. I don't know if we're the only ones, but
like maybe.
I don't think so.
Okay.
So as we were saying, what is Lisa really celebrating this holiday? So one of the tips is focus on your family and friends. The holiday is not just about the food. It's a time to celebrate your relationships with your friends and family. You know, where you've all been over the past year, how far you've come,
That's right. You
want to go, that you're thankful for one another, that you're thankful for your health, that you're thankful for your home, that you're thankful for all the great things in your life. So focus on the season and and really take time to revel in Thanksgiving before you jump into Christmas, because there is a holiday between Halloween and Christmas called Thanksgiving.
Right, yeah. The retailers may not know.
Right.
I think they've forgotten.
And it's a family time, and it's a time to enjoy, and it's a time to indulge. But, you know, just make sure that you remember why you're gathering with your friends and family.
What are you thankful for this year?
I am thankful for you.
Aw, I'm thankful for you too.
I'm thankful for this opportunity that we've had.
I'm thankful for this as well.
And for Sean's help.
Thank you, Sean.
Thankful for the fact that my sister is doing well. She had a car accident last Thanksgiving.
Agreed.
So thankful for that, and that my family is happy and healthy.
I am with you.
Yeah.
Couldn't be thankful for more than that, really.
Absolutely. So it's been a good year.
And we're thankful for you guys for tuning
Absolutely.
Back to the tips. Sorry. I got a little serious there.
That's what we're here for.
I'm going to tell you once again, you're going to fit it all on one plate.
Yes.
And that doesn't mean that you get to take the platter out of the closet and use that for the evening. Just a regular dinner plate.
I'm just picturing
Michelle's just getting,
right, with a big
because
platter.
I'm going to go up into the closet,
right,
and I'm
going to
take
down.
Out. Yeah. I'm going to keep the turkey
just
on the
so
roasting pan,
all in one
and I'm going to put it all on a platter. No, just a regular-sized dinner plate. Keep it there, one serving of everything, and that's it.
And if
it.
You're doing, not that this is really good for the environment, but if you're doing paper plates, get the smaller ones.
And they say that you should put your Thanksgiving dinner on the salad plate.
Yeah.
And
your
salad
on the dinner plate,
but we don't have salad at our Thanksgiving.
Right, no, that's weird. Anyway, make some substitutions.
That's right.
So that's really cool.
Yeah. So here's a way to shave some
extra calories.
So eat the white meat only and shave off 190 calories from your dinner.
Most people fight over the white meat anyway.
Yeah.
Make your own cranberries and save 120 calories.
Cut the marshmallows on the sweet potatoes and cut 100 calories.
Skip the green bean casserole and cut 110 calories. Or you can make the low-fat version if you have the ability to do so.
That's right. And choose the pumpkin pie over that pecan pie and cut 160 calories.
What's our total savings there, Lee?
650 calories.
That's mage.
That is mage.
Really mage. So you really might want to take some of that
for
seriously.
Those of you listening and not understanding what mage is, that means
major. So after you make some substitutions, there's also another Greatest article. Thanks, Greatest.
I know. I
they're awesome.
Couldn't come across, and it wasn't coming across any articles from Greatest, and I was like, this is a lie.
So the Greatest says how to enjoy Thanksgiving on any diet, and they give you tips if you are gluten-free, vegan, or if you have a nut allergy. It is kind of self-explanatory. I feel as though if you are gluten intolerant, if you are a vegan, or if you do have a nut allergy, you usually know what you can and cannot eat. Mm-hmm. But you may be surprised if you're new to it that there are hidden ingredients in everything. You definitely want to read ingredients, read labels, ask your host or hostess what they put in there. If you're catering, pay attention. For example, Dig In is catering Thanksgiving this year.
That's right.
And they list all the allergies on the bottoms of each of their sides.
Oh,
so they'll say
nice.
If there's a gluten, if there's a nut or a dairy allergy there for everyone. Because a lot of people these days do have allergies. So if possible, like I said, and if someone offers you something, just politely say no thank you. If in advance you can let your host know that you have an allergy, really no other questions asked. I can't consume gluten. I can't consume nuts, you know, and then maybe they can have an option for you there, or you can bring your own and they won't be offended when you pass on their great grandma's secret recipe that they're
so
proud of. You know, people really take the holidays seriously,
and
it means
absolutely.
A lot to them. So, of course, dinner rolls are not going to be gluten free, most likely, unless you get them from Toulouse, which we were hoping to do. They're probably won't be vegan because they will have milk in them. They mostly should be nut free, so you should be fine there. Turkey should generally be gluten free unless it's a processed turkey. Again, look at the label there.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not vegetarian or vegan. Self-explanatory. And it should be nut-free. Definitely not vegetarian or vegan. There. Mashed and sweet potatoes should be gluten-free, should be vegan. Be careful. They might not be nut-free, depending. And also, if you're talking about sweet potatoes and they put marshmallows on them, the marshmallows will probably have gelatin, which
that's
I believe
right.
is not.
Is it vegetarian?
Not
no,
vegan.
No, yeah.
Gravy will not be gluten-free. It will probably have flour in it.
We're going to make some gluten-free gravy.
We are.
I'm excited.
Gravy will not be vegetarian or vegan because it's usually made with a meat stock. It should be nut-free, though. Stuffing is definitely not going to be gluten-free unless you make a gluten-free stuffing. It may or may not be vegetarian or vegan, depending if your host used a nut.
A chicken broth or put sausage in it.
And then the same thing for the nuts. If they added nuts to it for the stuffing, then obviously it's not good for a nut allergy. Cranberry sauce should be gluten-free. If it has gelatin in it, it may not be vegan.
And if it's some, natural cranberry sauce, though, you should be good.
And some people do add nuts to their cranberry sauce, so just double check.
Interesting.
Green bean casserole will not be gluten-free if they use a soup that is not gluten-free. Mm-hmm. Might not be vegetarian because it might have meat broth in it, and it's creamy, so it's not going to be vegan either. Yeah, they did vegetarian vegan. All right. And then for the pies, we obviously they won't be gluten-free. They might not be vegan unless you get your own. They might be nut-free in the pumpkin pie, but you never know if anyone that you're at their Thanksgiving and they're gluten-free, they might have used a nut crust. So double check on that. But we will post this great article.
Yeah, that was very effective, that article.
Yeah.
The Holiday Fest by Sarah Engel of Self Magazine outlines, you know, what you should choose as far as a protein, a carbicide, and an extra. So she says that it pick one protein. So you may have multiple proteins at your Thanksgiving. You could have a turkey, a ham, or a pot roast. Just choose one. Carbicides, pick three, you know, out of the maybe six options that there are. And then also just pick one of the extras, maybe two, out of like the cornbread, the cranberry sauce, and the gravy. So, you know, just kind of like watch what you're piling on your plate. Try to keep it as balanced. We kind of get a little distracted about the whole eating holiday here.
Definitely. And finally, the last tip is to get active. There are plenty of turkey trots all over the country. Lisa found two really cool links. One of them is race360.com. They have ones everywhere in the United States. And then Running in the USA, we specifically went to the New York list. They're all over New York. I think there's a turkey trot in Garden City. I saw Port Washington. They're everywhere. So if you want to start your day off with some exercise so you can eat some extra calories because you burn them.
Go for it.
Hey, it's calories in, calories out.
Dinner usually doesn't start until like 3 o'clock anyway.
Yeah, definitely.
And so feel free to contact us for any additional tips about anything that we spoke about tonight.
Absolutely. So on to our Tabata of the week. We went with a traditional Tabata. You're going to do 20 seconds of squats with a 10-second break, 20 seconds of burpees with a 10-second break, and 20 seconds of push-ups with a 10-second break, and finally 20 seconds of jumping jacks with a 10-second break. You're going to repeat that for a total of 4 minutes.
And don't forget to do your thanks and planks from skinnyjeans.net.
Yeah, it's been really fun. So
it is pretty cool.
We want to just thank everyone again for tuning in. And
thank
it's really
you guys.
Been a lot of fun doing this for the past 19 episodes. Thanks for joining us for our show this week and every other week. As always, a huge thank you to Skinny Man and 3-1 for their help with the production of our show.
Thank you guys.
We will pull the beginning together with the end and edit that out for you guys. Join us in 2 weeks on December 3rd for more tools and tips for success. We'll probably be talking about running that night.
Yes.
So, and remember,
choose, commit, challenge, and change.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Have a great night.
Have a good night.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Have fun. Stay healthy. Don't gain weight.
Try your best.
Good night. Hold your head high, fingers to the sky. Even try and control ya, but they can't deny ya. Keep it moving higher and higher. Keep it moving higher and higher. So hold your head high, fingers to the sky. Now they don't believe ya, but they gonna need ya. Keep it moving higher and higher. Keep it moving higher and higher. I'm not going to be able to do that.